Hi, everyone. I'm Shweta Salunke. I'm part of the DynamoDB product management team. In this particular session, we'll go over Amazon DynamoDB's data protection capabilities. So what this will focus on is the different tools that DynamoDB provides or AWS provides that you can use to enhance your data protection for DynamoDB tables. Now in the slideshow, we'll go through preventative security best practices and detective security best practices. These would focus on more of the tools that you should be using so you can avoid certain data loss instances, accidental or otherwise, and avoid any sort of issues by setting up tools that can detect these in advance. Next, we'll go through how your DynamoDB tables can be backed up, how they can be exported to S3, how you can set up point-in-time recovery for your DynamoDB tables, and deletion protection, which was our latest launch. So starting off with preventative security best practices. Preventative essentially means you set these up in advance when you are creating your DynamoDB tables so that you understand like that your data is secure and that you can be completely aware of everything that's happening with your tables. So encryption at rest is one of the key ones that help you secure your Amazon DynamoDB data by supporting both AWS managed and customer managed encryption keys stored in AWS key management service. So encryption at rest is fully transparent to the users with all DynamoDB queries working seamlessly with the encrypted data. So this is not something where you will need application level code change to be able to read encrypted data. So that's really helpful. And you can also use your own specified keys or use AWS managed keys. The second thing that you can do to prevent any sort of insecure access to your data is setting up a VPC endpoint and policies to access DynamoDB. If you only require access to DynamoDB from a VPC or a virtual private cloud, you should use VPC endpoints to limit access from only the required VPC. Doing this prevents the traffic from traversing from the open internet and being subject to that environment. Using a VPC endpoint for DynamoDB allows you to control and limit access using VPC endpoint policies and IAM policies. So for more information, you can check out our website, which will lay out how exactly you can set up these endpoints for your Amazon DynamoDB tables. You can also consider client-side encryption, which is one of the best practices that we suggest. If you store sensitive or confidential data in DynamoDB, consider including client-side encryption in your plan. This way, you can encrypt data as close as possible to its origin and ensure its protection throughout its life cycle. So at the core, a DynamoDB encryption client is an item encryptor that encrypts, signs, verifies, decrypts your table items. So taking advantage of this becomes really important if you want to secure the access to your tables. The second preventative measure that you can do is role-based access controls. You can use IAM roles to authenticate access to DynamoDB. For users, applications, and other AWS services to access DynamoDB, they must include valid AWS credentials in their API requests. You should also not store AWS credential directly in your application or EC2 instance. These are long-term credentials that are not automatically rotated and therefore can have significant impact if they are compromised. You can also use IAM policies for Dynamo database authorization. So when you grant permissions, you decide who is getting them. With DynamoDB APIs, they are getting permissions for specific actions. So even with malicious intent or not, they can't really have access to all different actions at the same time. You can grant privileges to certain people who can delete the table, for example. So restricting that access would mean not all the users in your user base will have access to delete the tables. You would have restricted it only to the admins who are less likely to result in accidental deletes. You can also use IAM policies and conditions for fine-grained access control with DynamoDB. You can specify conditions that determine how a permission policy takes effect. So implementing least privilege is a key in this. As we went through with the delete option, you can avoid any sort of malicious or accidental activity by making sure you're granting permission to allow users that you trust to do the bigger actions, whereas grant permissions that allow read-only access, for example, to your wider user group. So now let's go through some detective security best practices. Detective security best practices basically revolve around setting up CloudTrail and capturing all the logs of your control plane operations. So you can use these for governance, compliance, operational auditing, risk auditing of your entire AWS account. With CloudTrail, you can log and continuously monitor every single activity that happens across your AWS infrastructure, including AWS DynamoDB. So CloudTrail provides event history for all of your AWS account activity, which includes actions that are taken through your AWS console, SDK, command line interface, or through the APIs. And this is done at no charge. So what would this give you visibility into? So you can look into who is using a resource. Did they modify it? When did they access it? Where did they log in from? Was it during a maintenance window? Was it otherwise? Who were the active users during an incident? What events occurred during that time period? And what actions did AWS take on your behalf? And many more actions can be tracked using your CloudTrail logs. So this not only helps as a compliance aid, this also helps you get all of this information so you can take corrective actions in the future. Now, let's go into backups. Backing up your data is very important for a multitude of reasons, whether it's disaster recovery or just for compliance purposes, et cetera. On-demand backups allow you to create full backups of your DynamoDB tables for data archiving or meeting regulatory requirements. You can back up tables from a few megabytes to hundreds of terabytes of data with no impact on performance and availability for your production applications. You can back up tables for any number of seconds, and you can do a point in time backup also. So in addition, you can also use continuous backups for point in time recovery, which we'll go through a bit later also. A quick summary of AWS backups. AWS backup is a fully managed backup service that makes it easy to centralize and automate your data protection. So you can use these policies across multiple services, including DynamoDB. So let's look at how exactly you can enable DynamoDB backups. So when you look at your console and you go to your particular table, let's say this is a table I'm looking at, there is a tab for you on the console specifically for backups. And this is where you can create your backup. When you click into that tab, here's what you will see. Go into the create backup button here. You can essentially set up what your default settings would be for your backup. You can either go with the default settings or use customized settings. There are multiple types of backups that you can set up. In the customized settings, you can choose whether your backup is managed by AWS Backup or DynamoDB. And you can choose to create a backup now or customize a backup window, which we can see how it looks. So essentially, like when you set up a backup with DynamoDB, you have limited capabilities. And here you can see the differences outlined also. With AWS backup, you also have backup encryption and ARN, including options for cross-region, cross-account tag, and storage. Whereas with DynamoDB, you can only have the encryption and ARN. So additional features are not supported. So depending on your requirements, you can choose either. So when you do your backup, you need to be aware that the backup is created per table. So in case you're using global tables where you have multiple replicas, each replica is considered a table. So if you want to backup each one of your replicas, you'd need to go to that particular region and make sure that you are creating the replica for your individual backup for your individual replicas. So now that we've gone through backup, let's look at exporting to S3. So exporting to S3 can also be done for regulatory requirements, or you are trying to get some actionable insights from your data. So this can be done by extracting your data and putting it into a data lake from S3. So there are ways to also have integrations with backup for your export to S3. You can select point-in-time recovery enabled backup and specify any point in the last 35 days and choose a target S3 bucket. This also works across regions, and there is no impact to your performance. So this is another way to make sure that you have recoverable data points at any point that you select in your timeline. Next, we'll go through point-in-time recovery. So with point-in-time recovery, we are talking about automated backups for your table. This is enabled through the console, CLI, APIs, or any other type of medium that you use to access your tables. Once enabled, this provides continuous backup until the option is turned off. When this feature is enabled, the customer has the facility to restore the database to any point in time within earliest restore data time and the latest restorable data time. So the data in point in time recovery is retained for 35 days only. And as a customer, you can restore the data to any point in time in those 35 days. So you can even restore your data to the previous 5 seconds. That's how point-in-time recovery would work. So let's go through how exactly deletion protection works. This is the latest feature that we've launched to make sure that there are no accidental deletes happening for your DynamoDB tables. Deletion protection helps you enable protection for your DynamoDB tables against accidental deletes during your regular maintenance operations. You can also use delete protection to set whether a table can or cannot be deleted during regular maintenance operations. This flexibility helps you ensure that mission-critical applications, applications that you use for your production data, is protected against deletion. So this can be used from the CLI API, cloud formation, et cetera, but here's how you would set it up on the console. So you go to the deletion protection area within your settings and turn it on. As you can see, it also shows very clearly what the current status is for this table. The deletion protection is off. So you can look at confirming your table name before you hit confirm for deletion protection. And then you can see the status update to deletion protection is on. There is also functionality to set up deletion protection across all of your tables. You can go to the list of your tables, and under actions, you can turn on delete protection after selecting any number of tables that you have. And finally, you can look at the status also in your tables summary page. Whether deletion protection is on or off for each one of your tables. So this list of protection capabilities can help you ensure that one, access to your data is controlled, and two, even during maintenance windows, you make sure that in cases of accidental changes or in case of malicious activities, you have a backup of your data. Thank you, everyone.